I have a conde guitar, which was made in Spain in the great workshop at number 7 Gravina Street, a beautiful instrument that I acquired over 40 years ago. I took it out of the case, I lifted it, it seemed to be filled with helium. It was so light. And I brought it to my face, I inhaled the fragrance of cedar, as fresh as the first day that I acquired the guitar. And a voice seemed to say to me, "You are an old man, and you have not said thank you. You have not brought your gratitude back to the soil from which this fragrance arose." Now, you know of my deep association and confraternity with the poet Federico García Lorca. I could say that when I was a young man, an adolescent, and I hungered for a voice, I studied the English poets, and I knew their work well, and I copied their styles, but I could not find a voice. It was only when I read, even in translation, the works of Lorca, that I understood that there was a voice. It is not that I copied his voice, I would not dare. But he gave me permission to find a voice, to locate a voice, that is, to locate a self that is not fixed, a self that struggles for its own existence. And as I grew older, I understood that instructions came with this voice. What were these instructions? The instructions were never to lament casually. And if one is to express the great inevitable defeat that awaits us all, it must be done within the strict confines of dignity and beauty.